Let's go ahead and get started. Chapter one has to do with the introduction to the real estate business itself. There are a number of things that we're going to be talking about as we go through. One is the Florida Real Estate Commission, the Division of Real Estate. We'll also be talking about Florida Statute 475. Now, these are all things and all individuals that regulate our industry. But to get started into this, I think that you need to understand the basics that you're going to have to know about and understand in order to become successful. First, property transfer. That's what this business is about. Selling real estate means that we're moving property from one owner to another owner. And we'll go in great detail about how this process takes place. Also, another thing that you're going to need to understand is, what is the current market conditions? Are we in a buyer's market? Are we in a seller's market? Exactly what is this market condition that we're in today? And finally, you're going to need to understand both sales and marketing techniques. And let me say this, listing and selling real estate is the name of the game in this business. So learning how to properly sell real estate and how to properly market the properties that we have listed is going to be crucial. Talking about the real estate brokerage operation itself, I think on the front side that you need to understand how this operates. Sales associates cannot work directly for the public. Only a licensed real estate broker in Florida can do that. Sales associates work for brokers. Now, associates can also work for unlicensed employers as well. But just remember that there's a process that as an agent, as a sales associate, you're a sub-agent of that broker who is actually employed by the general public. One great way to get started in this business is going to be to develop a farm area. And I can tell you right now, on the very front side of getting started, decide where you want that farm area to be. My suggestion is, why don't you pick out the subdivision that you live in? And the reason that you would do that is because you're familiar with it. You know most of the people that live there, and it would be an easy way to get in. But let me say this, that if you're going to pick a farm area, you need to spend at least 2 days a week, at least 2 hours each of those days, developing that farm area. Now, what are some of the areas of real estate that you're going to need to understand? There are several categories that we practice real estate. Probably the one that dominates the largest is going to be residential real estate. Now, residential real estate are those places where people live, such as single-family homes, duplexes, fourplexes, apartments even. Those are considered residential homes. And we market those a little differently than we would, say, a commercial property. Commercial properties are those properties that we work out of. Some other types of properties that we have to deal with, industrial properties, agricultural properties, and also business brokers. And let me say this about being a business broker. As a business broker, you're going to be selling personal property. No real estate license is required to sell personal property. However, generally speaking, selling a business, real estate is involved. So therefore, to be a business broker, operating a business brokerage operation, a real estate broker's license is going to be required to apply that aspect of selling real property. Now, that could either be the sale of real property or the lease, such as assigning a lease to a new tenant that's going to be selling that product. Let's talk about property management as it functions with real estate. Real estate comes in a number of packages. Mainly we think of it as sales, but I've got to tell you, property management has become very popular in Florida and the United States. And there's a primary reason for that, especially in Florida. A lot of people who buy investment properties in the state of Florida don't live here. And therefore, it's become very popular because of absentee ownership. Those absentee owners don't have the ability to manage their own properties. So therefore, they have to hire somebody to come in and do the management for them. Now, is there going to be a fee to that owner? Yes, there's going to be. So property management is a great way. And I got to tell you, a lot of real estate brokers have both sales departments and property management departments to make sure their business functions properly. Another aspect of our business that you're going to have to become extremely familiar with, and that is appraising. And what I want to do at this point is I want to separate appraising, because appraising can, there's two components to it. One is the appraisal itself, and the other is a comparative market analysis. And let me tell you what the difference is. The federal government a number of years ago passed some laws saying that any time that a bank makes a loan where there's a federally regulated lending institution involved, that whoever makes that value conclusion is going to have to be state certified. Therefore, Florida has implemented a state certified program for appraisers. It's Florida Statute 475, Part 2. Only individuals that are state certified can do an appraisal. Now, what can a real estate broker or a real estate sales associate do? We can value properties, but what we typically do is call those a CMA, a comparative market analysis. It's kind of like a mini appraisal. The appraisal has real strict standards. The USPAP standards is what we call it. And there are certain guidelines that they have to go through. Whereas when we do a CMA, we don't go through those same guidelines. So let's just make sure that we understand that appraisers do appraisals because they're state certified. Real estate licensees typically do CMAs because that is not under the appraisal umbrella as far as Florida Statute 475 Part 2 is concerned. Also remember, a lot of banks were hiring brokers to do a BPO. That's a broker's price opinion. Well, that's very much like a CMA. It is not an appraisal. It's just a methodology of determining the price of a property or the value of a property on behalf of a bank. Financing is also going to be a big part of our business, and you're going to need to understand the financing part. Remember, those folks in the financing business have their own license, and we can't participate in that. And the only time that we can is that if we're properly licensed. Developing and construction is also going to be a big part of our industry. Anytime that a developer goes in and decides to do a development project, the first thing that they've got to consider is the land and that land acquisition. And as they're developing the land, there's going to be a lot of components to it to make sure that that development project can be developed. There's going to be a subdivision plat map that's going to have to be acquired through either the city or the county before any developer gets started. And let me tell you what that subdivision plat map is. The developer is simply going to do a layout of his vision of what he thinks that subdivision should look like. It'll have roads, it'll have infrastructure, it'll have all the components of a subdivision. It simply won't be built yet. Once the city or county approves it, then and only then can that developer get started in building those homes or developing that project. Now, oftentimes what happens is that a developer gets into a project and has to make a decision about the infrastructure, about the roads. Do they want the type of community where the property owners that are in that subdivision contribute and pay for the upkeep of the roads and the infrastructure? Or do they turn that over to a city or county and allow them to pay for it? In other words, let the community taxpayers pay for it. If they decide to turn roads and infrastructure over to the city or county, that process is known as dedication, a very important process. Once construction starts, builders look at several aspects. They can either go in and do spec buildings, and let me tell you what spec building is. Build it and they will come. In other words, what that builder's doing is they're building a home without a buyer. And what they're hoping is that once they build it, a buyer will show up and buy it. A custom home, on the other hand, is a totally different situation. That builder already has a client that has a piece of land. And they probably already have a development order or the development plan. And that builder is going to build on that owner's lot. I think the easy way to remember the difference between spec building and custom building, in spec building, the builder is going to build on his own lot in hopes of selling it. In a custom lot, they're going to be building on the owner's lot already paid for, knowing the end result. I'm not going to get too much into the role of government, but let me say this, that local government typically is going to be dealing with zoning issues and building permits. They're probably going to be the ones that we look to more than anybody else. Whereas state governments are more into the environment. They want to make sure that our environment is clean and safe. The only role that the federal government really has is when it comes to financing, to making sure the banking system has the funds available for buyers and sellers to be able to interact out there, and also having to do with civil rights and other type of federal legislation regarding the housing industry. And I think that's all we're going to have for Chapter 1. So what I'd like to do right now, I'd like to go ahead and get into a complete review of what we just went over. Okay, Chapter 1, the introduction to real estate business. Farming is a great way to develop a real estate business. Property management is popular because of absentee ownership. Appraisers must be state certified and follow strict USPAP guidelines to do appraisals. Remember, this is for federally related lending institutions. These are the only ones that need to be state certified. Developers turn over roads and infrastructures to government through something called dedication. Spec building is building with the hopes of selling a property and is typically built on the builder's lot. Custom building is building on the owner's lot according to the owner's plans. Developers are required to get subdivision plat maps approved before starting any project. Licensees can perform CMAs for a fee, but typically offer this as a free service as part of their services to real estate. Appraisers are paid based on the amount of work done and not a percentage of the value of the property. Local governments determine zoning laws. An appraisal is a supported, defended estimate of the value of property rights as of a given day. Remember, an appraisal is an opinion. And that's all we have for Chapter 1's review.